When preparing yeast spreads, the first step and the step that is the most crucial is going to be activating your yeast. There are several ingredients and tools that you are going to need to complete this step. For this particular recipe, we are going to be using instant or fast-acting yeast. This is going to allow our yeast to rise faster than a traditional yeast. We also have olive oil. The purpose of olive oil is to not only add tenderness to our dish, but as we are kneading and shaping our bread, it is going to allow it to be a little bit more pliable. Next, we have sugar. Sugar is ultimately going to be the food for the yeast and help in the carbon dioxide formation. Next to that, we have salt. Salt is going to inhibit yeast growth and slow it down. That way we can control the activation process a little bit more. After the salt, we have our water. Our water needs to be between 120 and 130 degrees Fahrenheit. This is a very specific range. We need the water to be hot enough to activate the yeast, but if it is any hotter than 130 degrees, it can kill the yeast. Killing the yeast can lead to bread that won't rise and will be very flat and dense. If it doesn't activate, the same thing is going to happen. In terms of the equipment needed, we have a thermometer to take the temperature of our water. We have a mixing bowl and a whisk. The first thing you need to do is make sure that your water gets up to temp. The easiest way to do this is to simply pop your liquid measuring cup into the microwave and put it in there for about a minute on 100% power. Now, when taking the temperature of your water, you want to make sure that you first take your thermometer and you give it a nice stir and make sure that your thermometer is not touching the sides or the bottom in order to get an accurate reading. Since we are between the range that we need, we are going to move on to the next step quickly. For this next step, I am going to take my water and pour it into my bowl. I'm then going to add in my sugar, my salt, and my oil. You're going to give that a quick stir just to incorporate all of your ingredients. Next, I want to take my yeast and I just want to sprinkle it right on the top of this mixture. I don't want to mix in the yeast because we run the risk of overworking it and the activation process will not begin. After about a minute of being in the bowl, you should start to see bubbles that are forming. Here's some yeast that hasn't quite activated yet, but you should start to see this foamy layer starting to form on top. You should also notice a very yeasty or beer-like smell coming from the bowl. This is a really good indicator that your yeast is activating properly. We're gonna go ahead and give this another minute or two to finalize its activation process. Okay, so at this point, about 10 to 12 minutes have elapsed. You'll see that we have a lot of foam layer right here. We do have small little patches of yeast that hasn't quite gotten foamy. However, since we are using a rapid rise yeast, this is totally okay, and we are getting a very strong yeast or fermented or beer-like smell coming from the yeast, which again is a really good indicator that we are right where we need to be. So at this point, you have successfully activated your yeast.